Good morning, children. Today we are going to learn imaginary roots. So we are going to see a theorem. Theorem 3.2. Complex conjugate root theorem. Complex conjugate root theorem. So this is the name of the theorem. So we are going to see this. So if a complex number z naught is a root of a polynomial equation. So if the polynomial equation is p of x, say. So if z naught is a root of a polynomial equation with real coefficients, then its complex conjugate. So what is the conjugate of z naught? Z naught bar. So then z naught bar is also a root of p of x, we are going to prove. So I'll repeat once again. If z naught is a complex number which is a root of a polynomial equation p of x, then z naught bar, that is the conjugate of z naught, is also a root of the polynomial. So consider the polynomial p of x. So p of x is equal to a n x power n plus a n minus 1 x power n minus 1 plus etc. up to a1x plus a0. So let this be the polynomial equation which is equal to 0. So polynomial equation, therefore it is equal to 0. So this is with real coefficients, that is an, an minus 1, etc. up to an, a0 are all real numbers. So let z naught be the root of this polynomial. So if z naught is the root, what we get? P of z naught is equal to, in the place of z naught x, we have to substitute z naught. So P of z naught will also be equal to 0. So now we'll consider P of z bar, z naught bar. So P of z naught bar will consider. So in the place of x, we have to write now z naught bar. So an z naught bar power n plus an minus 1 z naught power n minus 1 plus etc. up to a1 z naught plus a0. So here we know that we have learnt this result. z bar power n is equal to z power n bar. So bar is nothing but the conjugate. So this result we know. Therefore this can be written as also an minus 1 etc. are all real numbers. Therefore, they are all real numbers. Therefore, in general, AR is equal to AR bar. Therefore, AN can be written as AN bar, and Z naught bar power N can be written as Z naught power N bar plus AN minus 1 bar z naught power n minus 1 bar plus etc. up to a1 bar z naught bar plus a naught bar. So now here we know that z1 bar into z2 bar is equal to z1 z2 the whole bar. Therefore this can be written as an, it can be written as an z naught power n the whole bar plus a n minus 1 z naught power n minus 1 the whole bar plus etc up to plus a 1 z naught the whole bar plus a naught bar. So now this in general we also know that z1 bar plus z2 bar z plus z2 bar etc is equal to z1 plus z2 plus z2 etc the whole bar. Therefore this can be written as a n z naught power n plus a n minus 1 z power z naught power n minus 1 plus etc up to a 1 z naught plus a naught the whole bar. Okay, the whole bar we can take. So what is this now? It is p of z naught the whole bar. So p of z naught the whole bar, which is equal to, that is p of z naught the conjugate, zero conjugate, which is equal to zero. So we have proved that p of z naught conjugate is equal to zero. Therefore z naught conjugate is also a root of p of x. So what is the theorem? Z naught is a root of the polynomial, then z naught bar is also a root of the given polynomial. So p of x, so we see here that conjugate roots, that is complex roots, occur in conjugate pairs. Complex roots occur in pairs. So this theorem tells us that complex roots always occur in pairs. So now we'll see example 3.8. So what is the example? Find the monic polynomial equation of minimum degree with real coefficients having 2 minus root 3 I as a root. So now what is a monic polynomial? So we know quadratic polynomial, cubic polynomial, quartic. Polynomial of degree 4 is called as a quartic polynomial. So what is monic polynomial? If p of x is equal to a n x power n plus a n minus 1 x power n minus 1 plus etc up to a naught to say, then this a n is called as the leading coefficient. This is called as the leading coefficient, and a n x power n is called as the leading term. It is called as the leading term. So when this an, when an is equal to 1, that is the leading coefficient is 1, then the polynomial is called as monic polynomial. So when an is equal to 1, the polynomial is called as monic polynomial. So what is the question now? Find the monic polynomial equation of minimum degree whose root is 2 minus root 3i. So one of the root is equal to 2 minus root 3i. So we have seen in the theorem that complex roots occur in pairs. Therefore what about the other roots? So the other root is equal to 2 plus root 3i. So we have to change the sign only of the for the imaginary part. So 2 plus root 3i. So now you find the sum of the roots. So what about sum of the roots? We have to add both. So add both the roots. Sum of the roots is equal to, so this root 3i minus root 3i and plus root 3i gets cancelled. So you get 4. And what about product of the roots? So product of the roots we multiply both. So it is equal to 2 minus root 3i into 2 plus root 3i. So it is of the form a plus ib into a minus ib. So in a complex number we know that it is a square plus b square. So it is 2 square plus root 3 square, which is equal to 4 plus 3, which is equal to 7. So now we have to form the monic polynomial equation. So therefore the required equation, so the required equation is, we know that it is x square minus sum of roots into x plus product of roots is equal to 0. So here we get x square minus 4x plus 7 is equal to 0. So see here, the coefficient of x square is 1. So we have got the required monic polynomial. Okay, now coming to the next theorem. Theorem 3.3. So theorem 3.3, this is also an important theorem. Let P, Q be rational numbers. P and Q be rationals such that root Q is irrational. So root Q is irrational. So you know what is irrational? Rationals. Rationals are of the form P by Q, where Q is not equal to 0. And what about irrational? You know examples, root 2, root 3, root 5, root 7, all these are irrational numbers. So root Q is an irrational number here. So if P plus root Q, P plus root Q is a quadratic, root of a quadratic equation with rational coefficients, then P minus root Q is also a root we have to prove. Okay. So if P plus root Q is a root of a quadratic equation with rational coefficients, previous theorem we saw for real coefficients, here it is for rational coefficients, then P minus root Q is also a root of the same equation. Okay, now, so let P plus root Q be the root of the equation x square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So P plus root Q is a root of this equation where b and c are rationals. So let alpha be another root. Alpha be another root. So what about sum of the roots? Sum of the roots is equal to alpha plus p plus root q, and that is equal to, from the equation, it is minus b by a. So a here is 1, so it is equal to minus b. So we get alpha plus root q is equal to minus b minus p, and this you assume it as s. Minus b minus p, you assume it as yes. So we get alpha plus root q is equal to yes. So from this we get alpha is equal to s minus root q. So what about product of the roots? So product of the roots is equal to p plus root q into s minus root q. So multiply this, we get p s plus root q s, then minus p root q minus root q square, so it is q. So it is equal to P S minus Q plus root q into s minus p. So this is the product of the roots, and this you take it as c, where c belongs to q. Q is a set of rational numbers, so we'll take it as q. So here we have seen that root q is irrational, but c is a rational number, therefore s minus p must be equal to 0, because root q is irrational, s minus p must be equal to 0. So from this we get s is equal to p. So when s is equal to p, what we have assumed for s is alpha plus root q. So alpha plus root q is equal to p. So from this we get alpha is equal to p minus root q. So we have come to the result that if p and q are rationals and root q is irrational, and if one of the root is p plus root q of the equation, then p minus root q is another root. So hence the theorem. Okay, now coming to examples. So example 3.9 is simple, you can take it for homework. Example 3.11. So it is, show that the equation 2x square minus 6x plus 7 is equal to 0 cannot be satisfied by any real values of x. So here we'll find the discriminant. So we have seen already that delta is the discriminant, and delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. So what is a here? A is equal to 2, b is equal to minus 6, and c is equal to 7. So substitute here, we get minus 6 the whole square minus 4 into 2 into 7, so which gives us 36 minus 8 into 7, 8 sevens are 56, so which is equal to minus 20. So minus 20, so it is less than 0. So we have got that delta is less than 0, which tells us that the roots are imaginary. So because the roots are imaginary, we conclude that the given equation cannot be satisfied by any real values of x. Okay, now coming to the next example. So roots are imaginary, therefore the equation cannot be satisfied with real values of x. Okay, next example. Example 3.12. 3.12, given equation is x square plus 2 into k plus 2 into x plus 9k is equal to 0. So given it has equal roots, we have to find k. So equal roots, so when does an equation has equal roots? When the discriminant b square minus 4ac is equal to 0. So here what is a? A is equal to 1. Comparing with ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, a is equal to 1. B is equal to 2 into k plus 2, and c is equal to 9k. So substitute here, b square, so 4 into k plus 2 the whole square minus 4 into 1 into 9k. So it is equal to 4 into, use a plus b the whole square identity. So k square plus 4 plus 4k minus 36k. So it is equal to 4k square plus 16 plus 16k minus 36 is equal to 36k. So it is equal to 4k square minus 20k plus 16. Now given this is equal to 0, given it has equal roots, therefore this is equal to 0. So we can divide throughout by 4. So it gives us k square minus 5k plus 4 is equal to 0. So you know how to factorize this. So what are the roots? K minus 4 and k minus 1. So when you multiply minus 4 and minus 1, we get 4. When you add both, we get minus 5. So minus 4 and minus 1 are the roots. So k minus 4 is equal to 0 gives you k is equal to 4, and k minus 1 equal to 0 gives you k is equal to 1. So we have found the values of k. So next, coming to example 3.13. Example 3.13. Show that if PQR are rational roots of the equation x square minus 2px plus p square minus q square plus 2qr minus r square is equal to 0. We have to prove that the roots are rational. So here again we will find delta. So a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 2p, c is equal to p square minus q square plus 2qr minus r square. So what about delta? B square minus 4ac. So it is equal to minus 2p the whole square minus 4 into 1 into p square minus q square plus 2qr minus r square. So this is equal to 4p square, and carrying p inside, minus 4p square. Minus 4 will carry inside. So minus 4p square plus 4q square minus 8qr plus 4r square. So we get, this both gets cancelled. So we get 4q square minus 8qr plus 4r square. So 4 is common, can be taken out. So we get q square minus 2qr plus r square. So what is it? By using identity, we can write this as 4 into q minus r the whole square. So this is whole square. So it is a perfect square. So because it is a perfect square, it is a perfect square. So because it is a perfect square, it will be definitely greater than 0. So greater than 0. So del is greater than 0. Therefore, we get only rational. The roots are rational. Okay, now we will come to another theorem. Theorem 3.4. Theorem 3.4. So here we have only the statement. So what is the statement? If P and Q are rationals, P and Q are rationals, root P and root Q are irrationals. P and Q are rationals, root P and root Q are irrationals, and also root Q be not a rational multiple of the other. That is, root P and root Q are not rational multiple of the other. Then if root P plus root Q is a root of the polynomial equation, then the other roots are, the other roots are, so if root P plus root Q is a root of the polynomial equation, then the other roots are root P minus root Q and minus root P plus root Q and minus root P minus root Q. So these are the other roots. So based on this, we will do example 3.10. So example 3.10. Form a polynomial equation with integer coefficient with root of root 2 by root 3 as a root. So we have to form a polynomial equation with integer coefficients with square root of root 2 by root 3 as a root. So square root of root 2 by root 3 is a root of the polynomial equation. Therefore, we take x minus square root of root 2 by root 3 is a factor. This we know that. So, is a factor of the polynomial. So, now to remove the square root, we have to find the other root also. So, what about the other factor? So, other factor, so the other factor is x plus square root of root 2 by root 3. So, this is the other factor. So now what about their product? X minus square root of root 2 by root 3 into x plus root of root 2 by root 3. So what is this? It is of the form a minus b into a plus b. So we get a square minus b square. So we get x square minus, only the whole first root will be removed. So we get only root 2 by root 3, x square minus root 2 by root 3. So still now root 2 and root 3 are irrationals. Therefore, we have to include another root. So what about the other factor? So other factor of this, the other factor, one of the factor is this, x square minus root 2 by root 3. So the other factor is x square plus root 2 by root 3. So now again you find the product. So what about the product of this both? So product is equal to, product of the factors is equal to x square minus root 2 by root 3 into x square plus root 2 by root 3. So here again a minus b into a plus b. So we get a square minus b square. So x square the whole square gives you x power 4 minus root 2 by root 3 the whole square gives you 2 by 3. And it is equal to 0. So taking LCM, we get 3x power 4 minus 2 by 3 is equal to 0, which gives us 3x power 4 minus 2 is equal to 0. So which is the required polynomial equation with integer coefficient. Okay, now we'll come to the example 3.14. Example 3.14. Example 3.14 and 5th question in the exercise are similar. So it is given, prove that the line cannot intersect a circle at more than 2 points. So what is the equation of a line? We have to prove that the line cannot intersect a circle at more than 2 points. So equation of the line, we know already. So equation of the line is y is equal to mx plus c. And what is equation of the circle? So equation of a circle is, circle at the origin we know, x square plus y square is equal to r square, where r is the radius and center is the origin. So here substitute for y square is equal to, y is equal to mx plus c. So take this as equation number 1 and this as equation number 2. Substitute 1 in 2. So substituting 1 in 2, we get x square plus mx plus c the whole square is equal to r square. So expand this, x square plus m square x square plus c square plus 2mcx minus r square is equal to 0. So we get here x square into 1 plus m square plus 2mcx plus c square minus r square is equal to 0. So if you see here, this is a quadratic equation. So it is a quadratic equation, mcx plus c square minus r square is equal to 0. So this is a quadratic equation, and we know that a quadratic equation has only two roots. Therefore, a circle and a line cannot intersect in more than 2 points, because this equation will have only 2 roots. Okay, now coming to exercise 3.2. Exercise 3.2, first question. If k is real, discuss the nature of the roots of the polynomial equation 2x square plus kx plus k is equal to 0 in terms of k. So we have to discuss the nature of the roots. So here, comparing with ax square plus bx plus c, a is equal to 2, b is equal to k, and c is also equal to k. So now find the discriminant, delta. So what is delta? B square minus 4ac. So it is equal to k square minus 4 into 2 into k, which is equal to k square minus 8k. So delta is equal to k into k, taking k out, k minus 8. So now we are going to discuss the roots. First one, when k is equal to 0 and k is equal to 8, k equal to 0 and k equal to 8, delta will become 0. So this tells us the roots are equal. The two roots are equal. Then second one, when k is greater than 8, when k is greater than 8, so we get delta will be greater than 0. So here we get roots are real and distinct. So distinct is different. Two different roots we get. Then next case, when delta is, k is less than 0, when k is less than 0, so we have delta is equal to k into k minus 8. So when k is less than 0, k is less than 0, we get delta also will be less than 0. So because this k will be negative and here also it will be negative, so negative into negative it will be positive, sorry, so it will be delta greater than 0. So in this case also the roots will be, roots are real and distinct. Then the fourth one, when 0 is less than k, less than 8, that is k is between 0 to 8. When k is between 0 to 8, we get delta is equal to, delta will be less than, delta will be less than 0. Because it is less than 8, so here k minus 8 will become less than negative, therefore it will be less than 0. Therefore in this case the roots are imaginary, roots are imaginary. Then coming to question number 4, fourth question, find a polynomial equation of minimum degree with real coefficients having root 5 and root minus root 3 as a root. So root 5 minus root 3 is a root. So we have seen in theorem 3.4 the other roots. So what are the other roots? So the other roots are, other roots are root 5 plus root 3, then minus root 5 minus root 3, and minus root 5 plus root 3. So these are the other three roots. So now it is asked to find the polynomial equation. So we have to find the equation. So first we'll consider the first two. So what are the first two? So root 5 and root 3, and root 5 plus root 3 will take. So what about the sum of the roots? Sum of the roots is equal to minus root 5, 3 and plus root 3 gets cancelled. So 2 root 5, and product of the roots so product of the roots is equal to a minus b into a plus b. So a square minus b square, root 5 square minus root 3 square. So it is equal to 5 minus 3, which is equal to 2. So what about the equation? Therefore the equation is x square minus 2 root 5x plus 2 equal to 0 is the equation. Now with the other two roots are, so the other two roots, what about the other two roots? Minus root 5 minus root 3 and minus root 5 plus root 3. So what about sum of the roots? So sum of the roots is equal to minus 2 root 5, and product of the roots is equal to minus root 5 the whole square minus root 3 the whole square, a square minus b square. So it is equal to 5 minus 3, which is equal to 2 again. So now here the equation, what about the equation? So the equation is x square minus plus of minus. So plus 2 root 5x plus 2 is equal to 0. So combining both, what we get? X square minus 2 root 5x plus 2 into x square plus 2 root 5x plus 2 is equal to 0. So we know multiplication now. So just we have to multiply. So with x square, when you multiply, x power 4 plus 2 root 5x cube plus 2x square. Then with minus 2 root 5x, so minus 2 root 5x cube minus 4, 4 into 5 x square minus 4 root 5x. Then with the 2, plus 2x square plus 4 root 5x plus 4 is equal to 0. So here what all gets cancelled? This plus 2 root 5x cube and minus 2 root 5x cube gets cancelled. So this is equal to x power 4. So this is x power 4 plus 2x square plus 2x square. So 4x square, and we have minus 20x square. Then 4 root 5x and minus 4 root 5x also gets cancelled. Plus 4 is equal to 0. That is x power 4 minus 16x square plus 4 is equal to 0, which is the required equation. Okay, now coming to the last question. You can do it for homework. It is same as example 3.14. So there circle and a straight line was given. Here it is given for straight line and parabola. So a straight line is y is equal to mx plus c, and parabola, equation of parabola. Now you will be learning only in the fifth chapter. By now you assume it. So y square is equal to 4ax. So take these two equations, substitute and frame a quadratic equation. Then you can say same as example 3.14, that they do not intersect at more than 2 points. Okay, thank you children. Do all these problems in your notebook and do the assignment problems also. Keep learning. Thank you.